It's not about perfection. I just try to get a feeling for the person's face, and it's always a good practice. I train my observation skills. I study the photo and the face of the person very precisely. Look closely at the things around you. I think especially in times of social media, it's important to question all the things we see on our daily basis. What do you think? Anyway, what's really important in a portrait are the eyes of the person you are going to paint. Especially the glance of the Mona Lisa is world famous. That's why it is so important for me that the eyes look almost identical to those of the original, which means that the proportions and the expression of the eyes have to be as similar to the original as possible. In her case, it's a little special. Not characteristic of the Mona Lisa is that she doesn't have eyebrows. Normally, the eyebrows are like a frame for the eyes. But there were times in which women shaved their eyebrows. However, in her case, the paint just faded out so that it looks like as if she doesn't have eyebrows. They say that the Mona Lisa originally had eyebrows and Da Vinci even painted them. What most viewers also don't realize is that the Mona Lisa is shrouded by a very fine veil. Until 2006, people didn't even know that this veil existed in the painting. Since then, experts assume that the woman we can see in the picture was pregnant at the time Da Vinci painted her. It's been common for pregnant women to wear such a veil at that time. As you can see, even nowadays people figure out new things about this painting. That's what makes it so mysterious and legendary. Equally mysterious and legendary is the smile of the Mona Lisa. People still wonder if she is really smiling in that picture, and if so, what might have been the reason. And since her smile is something so significant, I also tried to capture it just like I did with her eyes. It's those characteristics that make the viewer recognize this woman as the Mona Lisa. And I want people to recognize her. But still, she shall look different. At the end, it shall be my version of a classical masterpiece. Look very closely at the way I hatch. To me, it's not about creating a perfect drawing with many details. I just try to capture a moment. I try to draw the Mona Lisa the way I see her at this very moment. That's why I don't mind when things look a little spontaneous or even wild. I will paint over it anyway. And even though I draw in such a fast and wild way, I myself am rather calm and focused. It's not very good to feel stressed or to be under pressure while you're drawing. Some people rather see it as if they are dancing in front of the canvas, because you are constantly moving. You always have to take a step away from the canvas in order to get an overview of what you've created so far, which is a great life philosophy, by the way. Take a step back and get an overview of what you have done in your life so far. What are the things you did well, and what do you still have to work on? Art itself is actually very much connected to philosophy. Many questions come to your mind while you paint, and it's your job, the job of an artist, to find answers to all of these questions. job is to solve problems. And then, at the end, you stand in front of the finished painting, and you have no idea how you manage to create something like this. So as an artist, you should never focus on all the problems that are there. Instead, you should think about how you're gonna fix these problems. That's how the mindset of an artist works. But unfortunately, we don't have this mindset in our daily life. We focus way too much on the issues and scandals, instead of thinking about what we really have to change to make this world a little better. Because of this, many people actually called me an idealist and said that I am naive if I really think that way. However, to me it's kinda odd to live in a society in which idealism is put on the same level as naivety. Especially because it takes so much courage to speak up and to work on things that are good for everybody. Just as it takes courage to stand in front of a white canvas and to paint pictures like this. Nothing is more frightening than the freedom and the endless opportunities a white canvas or a blank piece of paper can offer you. And yes, sometimes I'm really scared to take a brush into my hand and to paint over all the things that I worked on so far. It's the uncertainty that can paralyze you, and the idea of doing everything correctly, which is why I see this spontaneous way of painting as a kind of therapy. It helps me to overcome this paralyzing perfectionism. Because you automatically make mistakes when you paint this way, and then you have to find a way to make the best of it. It's all about accepting the decisions you made earlier instead of regretting them. That means I paint the Mona Lisa the way I see her at this very moment. If I will ever paint her again, maybe in a year or something, she would definitely turn out differently. And that is totally okay, because this is all about enjoying and being in the moment. It's about making decisions and dealing with the consequences. For my version of the Mona Lisa, I decided to make the background look simple, but yet special. I use a color called Renaissance Gold, so it's a special shade of gold I use for the background. For the Mona Lisa herself, I use very striking colors that are high in contrast. That way, I hope she will come rest of the creative process. Now I still have a feeling for the proportions while I add one layer of paint over the other. Back in 2016, I had the chance to see the Mona Lisa in person. It's been my first visit to Paris, and all the impressions were quite overwhelming. There was just so much to see, so many historical buildings, and so many people at once. If you ever have the chance to visit Paris one day, I definitely recommend you to go there. To be honest, I don't want to live there, I think, because I am not the big city kind of guy. But I would most certainly visit Paris again. It was November when I went there, and it was kinda cold and cloudy. So the next time I would love to go there in spring or summer to see Paris in its whole beauty. I think everything is prettier when the sun is shining and when everything is green outside. Although the paintings were still spectacular, even in November. It's incredible to be surrounded by all these precious masterpieces. I mean, can you imagine that the Mona Lisa is more than 500 years old? And we can still look at her. Just think about how the world has changed in these 500 years. It's so funny to watch the people in the Louvre, how they stand in front of the paintings and try to make selfies. I'm sure even Da Vinci couldn't imagine that things like that would be possible in a few hundred years. And that people would still look at his paintings then. It's crazy how such a small painting can have such a big impact. But that is exactly the reason why I paint her now. To figure out if my version would have at least a bit of the impact that the original one has. By the way, something funny happened while I painted the Mona Lisa. At some point, I looked at the canvas and I noticed that she actually looked like the Russian president Vladimir Putin. I was so shocked that I seriously stopped painting her for a few days, because I thought I ruined it. I felt so bad and was full of self-doubts, until someone told me that it's well known that Vladimir Putin and the Mona Lisa look alike. I had no idea, but look it up on the internet. There are so many pictures where they compare these two, and yeah, they kinda look alike. Once I saw this, all my self-doubts disappeared, because in the end, I was doing a good job the whole time. Now I just had to turn Putin into a world-famous painting. And what I was trying to tell you is, if you are gets filled with self-doubt, don't let that discourage you. Continue with what you're doing. And if it's a portrait, look at the faces of the people around you. You will realize that there are often similarities between them. We actually don't look that different from each other. Like the people in Hollywood, they all have the same nose. Just focus on the painting process. Paint one layer over the other and think about the person you want to paint. That's what's so great about acrylic paint. You can just paint over all the little mistakes. It is kind of like modeling with clay, just that you're using paint instead. And after a while, you have a painting in front of you that you can be very proud of. Don't forget that it's just about having fun. The final part of my painting process is that I use some colored pencils to bring out the main points. I have made the experience that my paintings really benefit from this, because it basically underlines the spontaneous style of my portraits. And they also get a certain kind of sharpness. With them, you can accentuate a few details in a way that wouldn't be possible by just using acrylic paint. This way, the eyes look livelier and more defined. The same goes for the lips. With the colored pencils, I can make it look like as if there are little wrinkles, and I don't even have to go too much into detail. It just brings out all the significant parts of her face. You can even accentuate the hair this way, because the bright lines stand in great contrast to all the color fields. So all of this creates like kind of a tension, if you know what I mean, which makes a painting look more interesting. And then, when you are happy with the result, it's time to add your signature. In my case, I just write my initials on the canvas. And no need to hurry. Take your time when you're doing this. Who knows who is going to make a selfie in front of your painting in 500 years from now? I really hope that you enjoyed watching this video. Maybe you could relax a little bit, or you even fell asleep. That would be so cool. Anyway, if you are still awake, feel free to write me a comment and tell me how you like my version of the Mona Lisa. Maybe I could inspire you to create your own version of the Mona Lisa. If you want, you can send them to me on Instagram later. I would love to see your masterpieces. And don't forget, it's all about having fun. Just have a good time and be creative. Be yourself. Now I wish wish you a good night. Thank you for watching.